Good day, and welcome to Prayer Time with the Pastor. My name is Reverend Caressa Murray, and I am a co-pastor here at Covenant Presbyterian Church. And we are so glad that you are here with us this day to pause in the middle of our day and to spend time together in prayer, to listen to God's word, and to share our hearts with one another. Friends, we have been so blessed by technology that we have been able to offer worship every Sunday, and we continue to invite you to join us here on Facebook Live, as well as on our church YouTube channel and church website, covenantpresbyterian.org, to worship and to hear God's word each Sunday at 10:30. We will continue to do online worship through the months of June and July as we seek to uphold the safety and health of all. We will continue to offer you Wednesday at noon prayer time with the pastor, and we just hope that these offerings bring you closer to God and can bring you peace and hope in troubled times. If you want to know more about Covenant, you can go to our website, covenantpresbyterian.org. We have chapel videos for children that children and families can enjoy as they hear God's word and sing songs and pray together. We also have ways that you can give to Christ ministry through this place to help us with our ministries, to also provide for people who are coming to our door and desperately seeking financial assistance and help with different resources. And we are on the front line trying to provide for all of those who come to Covenant seeking help. So friends, today I want to turn our hearts to this word behind me, peace. We put this banner up for Sunday worship, and it continues to speak loudly to my heart in this time of trouble and turmoil. And so I wanted to purposely be here in the sanctuary and have peace behind me so that that can be our focus for this day, for this prayer time together. The Bible is filled with verses that bring peace in the middle of struggles, worries, and fear. And if we ask and seek and knock, God promises us a peace that passes all understanding. When we feel overwhelmed and we don't know where to turn or what to do, God calls us to step back from the pressures of life and come into God's presence and listen. Listen for how God is speaking peace into our circumstances. So friends, I start with this verse from 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7. Cast all your anxiety on me, because God cares for you. So friends, we come to cast all of our anxiety onto God because we know that God cares for you, that God cares for me. Hear these words from Philippians chapter 4, 6 through 9. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, Paul says, put it into practice, and the peace of God will be with you. Let us open in prayer. Lord, we come before you ready to pour out our worries, anxieties, and fears at your feet. We come to be still and know you, to claim and declare your promises for peace and strength over our lives. Bring peace into our soul that passes all worldly understanding, and make each of us a light for others to see your love, your hope, your strength, and experience your peace, O God. Amen. Today, for our prayer time, I invite us to come and rest in God's presence and immerse ourselves in God's word of peace. I've been reading several scripture passages, and I posted them on our Facebook page so that in the comments, so that you can read along with me. I think it's important that we do immerse ourselves in God's word and hear God's word of peace to us in this difficult time. So if you look at the post just previous to this one, I've got a list of scriptures that speak to peace, and I'm going to read a lot of those for you today. And I invite you to either follow along in your Bible, to read them out loud with me, or maybe you just need to sit and listen, to sit and absorb and hear God's words of peace being showered upon your life this day. So friends, let us open our ears to truly hear God's peace, and may our hearts be ready to receive that peace. From Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14, make every effort to live in peace with everyone and to be holy. Without holiness, no one will see the Lord. 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 9 through 11. Do not repay evil with evil or insult with insult. On the contrary, repay evil with blessing, because to this you were called so that you may inherit a blessing. For whoever would love life and see good days must keep their tongue from evil and their lips from deceitful speech. They must turn from evil and do good. They must seek peace and pursue it. From Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 15. Make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, but always, always strive to do what is good for each other and for everyone else. From Romans chapter 14, verses 17 through 19. For the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking, but of righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Because anyone who serves Christ in this way is pleasing to God and receives human approval. Let us therefore make every effort to do what leads to peace and to mutual edification. From Romans chapter 12, verses 17 through 21. Brothers and sisters, do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everyone. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath, for it is written, it is mine to avenge, I will repay, says the Lord. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. From the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verses 28 through 30. Jesus says, come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. And from the Gospel of John, chapter 16, verses 33. And Jesus said to the disciples, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. And from John chapter 14, verse 27, Jesus says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give. I do not give to you as the world gives. So do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Peace be with you. In the current reality of our world, there is little peace. Or at least it seems that way when you look at the TV or the news reports. And so, brothers and sisters in Christ, we have to seek a peace that is not worldly, but that is godly. A peace that comes from deep within, a peace that comes from growing and connecting with our Creator, Sustainer, and Redeemer. A peace that passes all understanding, a peace that comes from Jesus himself. A peace that reminds us of God's promises, of our participation in God's work and God's kingdom on earth, and our role to love one another. So friends, as we navigate these troubled waters, and as we try to combat the tidal waves of racism and protest and equality and lifting up police officers and first responders, lifting up lives that matter, lifting up one another in peace and love and care, we seek God's wisdom and we seek God's guidance. So friends, I want us to turn our hearts now towards God in prayer, and I will begin the prayer, and then in a little bit I will lift up specific prayers, and I invite you at the end of that lifting up of specific groups of people to respond with, Lord, hear our prayer. Friends, let us join our hearts and go to God. Lord, thank you for your promise and gift of peace. You are our peace. O Lord, the Prince of Peace who died on our behalf so that we could live and know true peace. Help us not to be afraid when trouble comes our way, but help us trust and rest in you at all times, regardless of what my feelings try to convince us to think or how overwhelmed we may be. Let us put our lives and our hearts in your hands, O God, and go to your word, sit in prayer with you to center ourselves in your peace. Lord, you know our country and our world is in great turmoil right now. We are overwhelmed with so many things, and we come now to seek your peace and guidance, your hope and love, as we lift ourselves and others in prayer. For those stricken with sickness, for those that have contracted, died from, or recovered from COVID-19, for those battling with cancer, for those anxious about their symptoms, for those in the hospital confined to their home, Lord, hear our prayer. For all medical personnel and support staff, who are working long hours away from their own family to heal the sick, to care for those stricken by this virus, to work for a vaccine and methods of care. Lord, hear our prayer. For police officers, sheriffs, deputies, all law enforcement, for first responders who are working to keep order, to protect people in their community, to uphold justice and show the nation their love, their care for others. Lord, hear our prayer. For people of color who have been and are marginalized, oppressed, face fear and injustice every day, whose voices have been drowned out by racism. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who seek to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with God, who care deeply for all brothers and sisters of every color, make, and model, who feel called to be and seek ways to be agents of God's kingdom in the here and now, who strive to listen like Jesus, to love others like Jesus, to bring peace and comfort like Jesus. Lord, hear our prayer. And Lord, now we lift up to you the concerns, our concerns or concerns for others that are on our hearts at this time, O Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. God, we pray for our leaders, for our national leaders, state leaders, local community leaders, for pastors, for all of those who are seeking to make wise, safe, healthy decisions for all people, who are working hard, countless hours, so that people can be safe and healthy, can live in their community, who can have what they need. Lord, hear our prayer. Guide us, O Lord, as we navigate these uncertain, troubled times. Enable us to find peace in you, and then go and empower us to be bearers of peace to this hurting world. We pray all of this, all that is on our hearts, all that has been said aloud, O God, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And all of God's children said, Amen. Friends, I leave you with this blessing from Romans chapter 15, verses 13. May the God of all hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Friends, the peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with you. Amen.